Congratulations on this fabulous, fabulous picture. And I want to ask you, what is the biggest challenge for you to take a biopic and, you know, do it when it's, especially when it's somebody as prominent and important as J. Edgar Hoover?
Well, biopics bring their own set of problems with them as far as how much you want to imitate or emulate the characters. And but Hoover was a very important character and controversial character. And so it's important to kind of get it somewhat accurate. It's the actors all pretty much studied and read every biographical piece of material they could find when once they got the roles. And I think they all enjoyed it, and they enjoyed diving in on it.
How much research did you have to do personally?
Well, I had a really good script from Lance Black, and it was so I had to just go back and look at the material that he took it from to make sure there wasn't anything missing. And for instance, there was a speech by Nixon who does a eulogy to Hoover, and in that he had sort of paraphrased it a little bit and taken it. But when we got to doing it, we had a film clip of the actual eulogy by Nixon. So I just put that up and said, told the actor, I said, just do that one. So you have to vamp as you constantly take in information on the person, on the character, and on all the characters,
yeah.
And listening to congressional interrogations on Helen Gandy after they wanted to know what happened to all the files, and there was a big curiosity about that.
Oh, I'm sure.
She just said she boiled them.
Had them for dinner.
Yeah. No, she shredded them all up, and they said, well, why'd you do that? She said, because that's what he asked me to do, and told them to buzz off from there on.
Yeah. Leo just hits it out of the park. He's so fantastic in this. How did you know that he was going to be able to tackle this role?
Well, I've watched him, his career advance from a young juvenile to a young man and playing a lot of different kinds of roles. He desperately wanted to do this. He had a great instinct for it, and so I think anybody who wants it that bad and who's as good a performer as he is, it was to my benefit. I would have been a fool to not advance that one.
He really went through the ringer with this. I mean, the makeup process,
yeah.
The studying. I mean, really, to watch him work Clint, what was it like? What impressed you most about him?
Well, he did that. I mean, it was extremely helpful. He even brought his own makeup person to help construct that, and it was a very arduous situation putting it on every day. It took 5 hours to put it on, 3 hours to take it off, and so it was very time consuming. So we had to schedule around it. So you would be doing. We tried to save the older part to do in 1 2-week period, so we didn't go back and forth and do all the younger part first, and then. But even in the younger part, there were certain little advances, like he gave himself a slight double chin as he got a little older, and tried to advance it gradually.
Yeah, the script is so wonderful, and having been written by Dustin Lance Black, it just. You know, there's so much talk about J. Edgar Hoover's sexuality and everything, and I thought you touched on it so well, because it really does leave it up to the audience to decide what really went on there. But, you know, how important was it for you to, you know, to deal with that and sit with Dustin and make sure that it was looked at properly?